In order to get that right turn, he's going to have to drift that Mark Twain right around the corner.
Believe it or not, the boats will now be Italian. It's going to be Tokyo Drift.
Oh, it's going to be Mississippi Drift, though.
Yeah.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Fresh Baked Disney, the best of Disney Baked Fresh Daily. That's a horse. It's coming right at you. High five that horse, Fresh Baked. How are you guys doing this morning? I am Dave, your host. And I'm here to show you the magic and wonder of Disneyland. I almost forgot what I was supposed to say. Guys, it is 9 a.m. on a Tinkerbell half marathon morning. This place is already bonkers. Are you feeling the bonkers?
Not quite.
Really?
Not quite yet.
I'm feeling the bonkers. I'm definitely feeling many bonkers. I've got Sarah with us here. Hi, Sarah. We got Liz with us today. Hi, welcome back, Liz.
I know. I'm sorry I've been gone for so long.
Yes, you should apologize. Apologize for that. Okay. Let's go down Main Street and feel the bonkers. Oh, and by the way, while we do that, why don't you watch our... We did a Star Wars Land update already this morning, you guys. Lots to see. It's Star Wars Land, you guys. Lots to see. This is going to be the coolest update. I'm gonna tease it for you. They moved some dirt. They moved the dirt. Good morning, Fresh Baked. Welcome to Star Wars Land. It looks different. See if you can spot, Fresh Baked, why Star Wars Land looks different this week than it did last week. Anyone? Ian, do you have any thoughts?
I think the dirt's taller.
The dirt is taller. Which dirt, Ian?
That dirt on the left.
This dirt up here?
Yeah.
I think you're right. I think that dirt... Okay, Fresh Break, you ready for this? That dirt has been moved. It was used to be over here. Fresh Break, they've moved the dirt. I think I just found that. That's the headline. They moved the dirt. Yeah, the dirt, there used to be dirt there. And they've made like a new grade. It's uphill. If you can see, it kind of goes uphill a little bit from this section right here. And it's a hummingbird. Oh my goodness. Yeah, here's like area two. Okay, and that's area one, I guess. That's area one. We'll call that area two. And then area three. Okay, so area two, you can see. We're not sure if that's old pipe or new pipe, but there's pipe nonetheless. They're getting ready to do foundational work, or they are doing foundational work. They might have already. It's possible. Do you think that they've already dug the foundation and filled it in again? I don't know. It doesn't look like they have. But they definitely have. I mean, they've definitely raised that a lot. That is definitely not a new... I mean, that is definitely a new level of dirt.
Yes.
Area 3 has been demoed. Last week we showed you guys that they were getting ready for the demo. Everything's been, once they get their mindset on this, they make it happen fast.
Yeah.
I mean, that seems like a pretty quick demo and removal of all the debris. Now, Ian, I have a question for you.
Yes.
Now that they've moved that dirt, let me move back in here. Now that they moved that dirt, what does that mean for the perimeter of Star Wars Land? Like, I was all set to believe that they were building a berm around Star Wars Land, right? Is it just gonna be that area back there then? Is this gonna be all flat like it is?
Well, I mean, first of all, this section has to be closed back up for the river at some point.
Oh, you're right.
So between the hill you can see further back and the closer one, that's going to have to be next.
They're going to close that up a little bit. So it's open now. You know what? It's open now for traffic. You can see there's a lot of traffic going in and out of there.
Trucks and all the machinery in and out.
Yeah.
At some point, that will close back up.
Now, a friend of Fresh Baked, Tommy LaFleur, sent me a couple pictures that I want to show you guys. So what Tommy has sent me is a Google Earth view of... Well, he's taken an old photo of the park, it looks like, and he's kind of cropped out, or not cropped, he's dropped in the show buildings and then shortened the river a little bit, and it's kind of useful because we get to kind of help visualize where things are in relation to what we're seeing. He's also, that white path that you see hugging the river, that's the new train path, I think, right?
Yeah, that would have to be.
And then the path that extends from it, the thicker one, is the footpath. It's the walking path that goes from Critter Country over here, perhaps, right about there. And it's going to come out and it's going to meet these three, you know, three areas. That's pretty neat. By the way, thank you, Tommy, for the effect of, he made the water reflective. He put a filter on the water so it reflects the things that are around it.
Oh.
Isn't that nice? It's very complete of him. Also, Tommy sent us another photo. Now, this one we're having a hard time getting our head around. Because it looks like it's a panoramic shot of the river. That if you look, it's just on the other side of this berm, right there. That's the river. But that's it's actually more than river. It's river plus other areas, I think. But according to this photo, makes it look like the river's turning right, right at the canoes. But that can't be right because we're looking at it now. If the Hungry Bear is right there, right? You can see the Hungry Bear right there somewhere. I can't see, so every week I do this, right? With my little disclaimer, I cannot see because it's too bright. But if the Hungry Bear is right there, the canoes are before that. That means that the river would be turning right and cutting down all those trees right there. So it is coming forward a little bit, but you can kind of get an idea where the river turns right now instead of, it's turning right at about where Settler's Cabin, where Mike Fink's cabin was. Yeah, that's where the river is. And you can see they've actually got cement down there. Now, you were saying that's some old cement, some new cement, maybe?
I think some of that's the old cement that was already just connected to the island they did it.
Right, okay. I don't see, so that's the thing, is I don't see, when I look here, I don't see any cement.
Because you're already past the end of the road.
Right, okay.
We're
that makes sense. Now, where that hill is, right there.
Yes, that's over by when we do our big thunder trail, right, because that orange fence is the one we can see by the
So
between that hill and here,
the river's turning right there though, right?
Yes.
That's a hard right also.
It's
don't you think?
It's gonna be a tight turn.
Now I wonder, are they gonna have, is the Steam Paddler and the Columbia, are they gonna be drifting cars? Like drifting cars, are they gonna be drift boats?
I assume so, this is.
Because he's gonna have to do that, right?
Oh, of course.
In order to get that right turn, he's gonna have to drift that Mark Twain right around the corner.
Well, in fact, the boats will now be Italian, so maybe Tokyo Drift.
Oh, it's going to be Mississippi Drift, though.
Yeah, exactly.
And scene.
Nicely said.
I want to see that happen. All right, fresh break. Let's go. You know what? I heard there's some people jogging. Let's go take a look at the joggers. So today, you guys, is the Tinkerbell Half Marathon. And what we're looking at there is their little staging area. That is enormous, you guys. I don't remember ever looking that big. They usually do this stuff in Downtown Disney. That's in the parking lot, I believe, at Downtown Disney. That is impressive. It looks like there's no joggers here. This is all after they're finished. They probably finish at that area there, and then they have to walk back to the Mickey and Friends parking structure here. Lots and lots of joggers. We're going to see people wearing those trauma blankets, snacking, drinking water, relaxing. You notice you don't see, you guys? Oh, wait, there's one. Okay, they are still wearing the Tinkerbell costumes. I was wondering if they were going to let them wear the Tinkerbell costumes because of that, you know, the cosplay rule. But maybe they get a waiver for the half marathon. There's a couple joggers right there that are wearing the Tinkerbell outfits, I think. Again, I cannot see very well because of the sun.
We've got lots more videos for you to see, so grab a churro and check out our Star Wars Land updates from the Knothole Gang, or maybe our Secrets and History videos. Or you can just watch all of our weekly trip reports and have your mind blown by how much fun we're having. We truly are the best of Disney Bake Fresh Daily. And don't forget, you can support Fresh Bake by joining our Patreon campaign or by buying a Fresh Bake t-shirt. Thanks again for watching, everybody. Fresh Bake!
So you're probably wondering, Fresh Baked, why did the Jungle Cruise close for so long? What did they do?